What's up with stealth games and public urination? Desperados 3 is a real-time tactics stealth game developed by Mimimi Games. Yes, these are the same people who developed Shadow Tactics Blades of the Shogun, only this time around you're killing bandits instead of samurais. The third entry is a prequel to 2001's Desperados Wanted Dead or Alive and follows the story of a young John Cooper on a quest for revenge. The game will take you through several locations, from the Rocky Mountains of Colorado, damp Louisiana swamps to the bustling city of New Orleans. Whether you're kicking scorpions in the desert or mingling with New Orleans' civilian population, mission objectives generally revolve around two overarching themes: eliminating as many enemies as possible without ideally raising the alarm and thwarting the plans of the DeWitt Company. As you can probably guess, Desperados 3 is as Western as it can get. The setting, story, characters have all the hallmarks and the cliches of this particular genre, from the young gunslinger with a score to settle, the wisecracking, physically imposing trapper to the cynical Civil War veteran slash gun for hire. I'll get back to the story later, but for now, I wanna give a huge shoutout to Tumbleweed Dealer. Their music, which is a blend of stoner rock and drone metal with a strong western flavor, is a perfect match for this game, so I wanna thank them for allowing me to use their music in this video. I'll leave a link in the description, so go check them out, they're awesome. So first, let's talk about the presentation. While it's nothing to write home about in terms of visuals, the unimpressive graphics work to the advantage of the game instead of dragging it down. You see, this is one of those games where mastering the craft of save scumming is not only vital, but actively encouraged. Desperados 3 has these huge, sprawling and bustling levels, so sacrifices had to be made in order to ensure the best possible performance as well as short loading times. This is not to say that Desperados 3 looks bad. In fact, I'd argue it's one of the better looking strategy games out there simply because it nails its setting so well. Desperados 3 is very immersive. I wouldn't necessarily call it realistic, but silly enough to help me suspend my disbelief and authentic enough to make me believe that all of these guys have diarrhea. Come on, it's the 1870s, everybody had diarrhea back then. The presentation is further enhanced by the great soundtrack and excellent sound design. The various environmental sounds and conversations between NPCs only add to the immersion and make all locations, whether urban or in the middle of nowhere, feel very lively. I'd also like to extend praise to the excellent production values. There's something very satisfying about throwing a knife into somebody's neck and imagining how they're regretting not taking that job at the local saloon as they're gurgling and gasping for air. Or seeing somebody's child getting their lower body mangled by a bear trap as they're presumably pondering the ethics of doing security work for a shady company that destroys communities for profit and practices slavery. Okay, now that we're done talking about the presentation, let's switch over to the gameplay. Like I said before, Desperados 3 is a real-time tactics stealth game in the same vein as the Commando series or the lesser-known Robin Hood, The Legend of Sherwood. Through the course of the game's 16 or so levels, you control between 1 and 5 people, depending on a mission. Each character comes with their own set of abilities, strengths, and weaknesses. John Cooper, which is the protagonist, sports a knife that can be thrown at or plunged into enemies and two trusty revolvers. He can also distract enemies with a perfectly timed coin toss. Hector can lure people into his bear traps by whistling and kill stronger enemies. He also loves to drink and talk with or about his bear trap as if it's a real person, which is kinda weird but funny at the same time. McCoy is the designated sharpshooter of the gang. Apart from taking out enemies from a distance, he can also inject his targets with a lethal dose of... I don't really wanna know what, to be honest. Kate is the de facto support character of the group and specializes in crowd control. If she finds a disguise, she can charm targets or distract them with chit-chat. She's also proof of how far we have come as an industry in terms of nut-kicking gameplay mechanics.
Phew. Got him.
Finally, there's Isabel. Oh man, she's something special. Isabel is not your typical Western character in the sense that she's neither a cowboy nor a rough-around-the-edges sheriff. Let's say she has a particularly unique set of abilities. She doesn't shoot people, she mind controls them and makes them shoot their friends. Or she links them up so that the nasty thing that happens to one happens to the other. And she has a cat that can be sent to distract enemies, kinda like that old dude and his tanuki from Shadow Tactics. The characters complement each other and are perfectly balanced between them. For example, Hector can carry two bodies at once, so he's the ideal choice when you take out multiple enemies in a short time frame and need to hide bodies fast. Cooper and Isabel are the only characters who can swim and climb vines, so they're perfect for exploiting the vertical level design. In short, this means that even if you have a favorite, you'll be forced to judge each situation on its own and figure out the best course of action. Desperados 3 is brutally difficult, but here the difficulty doesn't stem from bullet spongy enemies or other cheap tactics, rather smart enemy placement as well as genius level design. At its core, the game is about using the tools at your disposal to overcome impossible odds. There are no weapon upgrades, skill trees and level ups. All you get is all you have. The game design incentivizes players to master the limited number of tools and abilities and pay close attention to their surroundings. The tactical and strategic options are nearly endless. You can complete objectives and eliminate targets in whichever way you want. Picking off enemies one by one and hiding their bodies is just as valid an option as shooting them in the face with a sawed-off. I said it's a stealth game, but you can play it as a straight-out action title with no issues, provided you've planned ahead appropriately. It's nice having the option to just say fuck it and blast your way to the exit. But Desperados 3 truly shines when played as a stealth game, and it's clear that the levels and characters were designed with stealth in mind. You'll spend a lot of time scoping the maps, analyzing enemy patrol routes, planning your takedowns, failing, redoing the same sequence of events with minor adjustments only to inevitably fail. And finally, you nail it and feel like a master tactician. Remember when I said that the characters complement each other? Well, that becomes quite evident over the course of the first 5 levels when the game starts gradually introducing newer and tougher enemies. While distraction tools may seem OP during the first 2 missions, they don't do shit against ponchos and long coats who couldn't be lured away from their posts even if their cars caught fire, or wagons or whatever, I don't give a shit. Likewise, ponchos are immune to Kid's charm ability, while long coats and dogs can straight up see through her disguise. And remember Isabel's awesome voodoo magic? Well, it doesn't work on long coats, so yeah. This is when you'll discover the true power of teamwork. Ponchos and long coats can't be lured, but they can be temporarily blinded by Kate's perfume or McCoy's gas grenades. Is a long coat bugging you, but Hector's not around to stick an axe into his skull? Well, you can have one of your characters shoot him and send another to slash his throat from behind. When nothing else works, just grab a stick of dynamite and wait for the right moment. Easy peasy. But don't get too excited, because there's more to this game than eliminating targets through wacky Western antics. Research shows that the vid company employees are social animals, traveling, eating, sleeping and drinking only in packs. And if high school has taught me anything, is that the best way to deal with large groups of bullies is by going straight for the biggest and toughest of them all. That is, if you're stupid. The better approach here is to call a few of your buddies and engage in a satisfying session of carefully synchronized and overly stylized carnage. This was my convoluted way of introducing the showdown mode, one of the best gameplay mechanics in Desperados 3. Pressing the shift key pauses the game, allowing players to issue each character an order which can then be fired off simultaneously. It's an incredibly powerful planning tool that gives players complete control over the map. I'm making it sound like it's an incorporated cheat code, but it's not. In fact, it's almost required in many encounters, because remember, enemies roam in packs and they'll more often than not be guarding each other. Moreover, stealthing your way through civil zones can be particularly tricky, because there you'll have to worry about civilians, on top of regular enemies. Add the vision cone system and the fact that nearly everything you do creates noise, and the situation can seem especially hopeless at times. So the showdown mode helps you tip the scales slightly in your favor by allowing you to set up these complex sequences of pure stealth carnage. But even then, you're still not safe, because there are other mechanics at play, which I'm not gonna talk about in detail, because otherwise we'd be here all day. And let's not forget about the environmental kills.
Sorry, didn't mean that.
But one of the best things about the gameplay is that it encourages experimentation. Nothing is off the table, you can get as creative as you want. The very systems that the game has in place to limit players can be exploited to their advantage. For example, raising enemy suspicion levels by leaving trails of footprints is risky, but a viable strategy if there are no other apparent ways to lure them to your location. Before wrapping up with the gameplay, I want to highlight one particular moment that perfectly encapsulates the complexity and elegance of Desperados 3 gameplay mechanics. Later in the game, I was tasked with burning down a huge boat in the middle of the swamps. Problem is, I had to grab a torch from a bonfire which was conveniently guarded by like 5,000 enemies. I spent the better part of an hour trying to figure out ways to fend their numbers and sneak my way to the bonfire. But then the most dastardly of ideas crossed my mind. What if I use Isabelle's mind control ability on one of the enemies, grab a torch and burn the whole joint down? Nah, it can't be that simple, right? But it worked. And it was the best feeling ever. Finally, let's talk about the story. I don't think it's too controversial to say it's one of the weaker parts of the game. The story is as stock as you can expect. Gunslingers, cowboys, sleazy boomtowns, brothels, revenge, redemption, friendship. I can go on forever. Don't expect the thematic complexity of a Sergio Leone film. You won't find it here. However, it does a good job of contextualizing the missions, so that's enough, I guess. The strongest parts of the narrative are the funny writing and the camaraderie shared between its 5 playable characters. Their scripted banter highlights their unique personalities and makes each mission feel a little more special than the last. An early mission sees 2 characters make a bet to see who can kill the most enemies, and you can actually hear them call out their scores with each subsequent kill, which was pretty cool to be honest. A later mission takes place after a night of heavy drinking and sees the gang sneaking through droves of DeWitt cronies while nursing their hangovers. Their intoxicated state is even reflected in the contextual dialogue lines.
No problem.
Kate. Wake up.
Oh god. My head's gonna burst wide open.
Just gotta stay upright.
The game is filled with these nice little touches that add some color to the cliche narrative. Alright, that wraps up my review of Desperados 3. I was planning on ending this video by pleading with MiMiMi to buy the rights to Commandos, but apparently another studio is already working on a sequel. I'm a bit skeptical, but hey, this genre was effectively dead until 4 years ago. If other studios are willing to make RTTs, it means that there is still a market for these games, which makes me very happy. Thanks for watching. As always, please consider hitting the like button and subscribing for more content. I'll see you next time.